The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department reaffirms its commitment to support the over 200 Filipinos who fell victim to an alleged illegal recruitment scam in Italy. Reports say some Filipinos paid 3,000 euros to a recruitment agency known as Alpha Assistenza for the processing of their employment documents in the country. However, the agency issued fake documents to the victims, who are now taking legal action. The DFA reiterates it will provide legal aid to the victims.
We told them that we are going to, we're going to pay for your legal representation. It's just a matter of deciding, they could decide themselves who will represent them in Milan. Pag nandun nagreklamo mismo sa Milan, when I was there, were about 70. And they represent more. They represent not just themselves.
Yes.
But like one might be trying to get documents for two people or three people.
Uh-oh.
Department of Migrant Workers sent, they said they're sending a team fact-finding to strengthen the evidence. Sorry.
Some parts of Batangas and Laguna suspend classes Monday due to volcanic smog from Taal Volcano. Some residents have complained of difficulty in breathing as the fog once again affected parts of the two provinces Sunday. But state volcanologists say the situation is becoming better and the fog that's now subsiding. Taal remains under alert level 1.
Ngayon po, very clear na po yung Taal Volcano. Okay. Very visible na po yung main crater and wala po tayong nakikitang bug na namumuo. While in fact, yung steaming or yung plume na nakikita natin, madali po siyang ma-disperse. Hindi siya namumuo kasi mabilis po yung hangin ngayon. Umaabot po ng 3 to 5 meters per second wind speed. Kahapon, medyo mabagal kaya siguro na concentrate po ito sa mga areas na malapit sa Taal Volcano. Preemptive yung ginawa ng LGU kahapon. Okay.
Good news for motorists. A big time price rollback, set for Tuesday. Gasoline will see the biggest price cut of 3 pesos and 5 centavos per liter, while kerosene prices will go down by 3 pesos. A liter of diesel will also see a 2 peso and 45 centavo markdown. This is the third straight week of oil price cuts and the biggest one following an 11-week streak of fuel price increases. The rollbacks, though, could be short-lived. That's because global oil prices have jumped 4% due to the war between Israel and Hamas. The first day of the jeepney fare hike marred by confusion among passengers and the drivers themselves. The provisional 1 peso increase in jeepney fares took effect Sunday, but some drivers have yet to charge passengers the higher fare, citing a lack of knowledge about it. Some commuters, meanwhile, are asking for a fare matrix before giving in to the fare increase. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board has already clarified it will not issue a fare matrix since the increase is provisional. Meanwhile, the LTFRB will hold hearings on the main petition for a 5 peso fare increase on November 24th. Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno sees a better economic performance for the country in the second half of the year on the back of stronger government spending. The Philippine economy grew 5.3% in the first half. Government underspending has been cited as one of the reasons for the lackluster GDP print. Diokno now says this will improve as national agencies implement their spending catch-up plans. He adds infrastructure projects, which he expects will be done during the fourth quarter, will also contribute to the country's growth. More than 2,400 people have been killed in earthquakes in Afghanistan. The Taliban government said Saturday's quakes that hit the western region are the deadliest tremors to rock the country in years. The strongest tremor registered at magnitude 6.3. Officials expect the death toll to rise as they assess the damage in remote parts of the country. More than 9,000 others were also injured. Remnant of Typhoon Koinu brings floods to Hong Kong a month after the city was paralyzed by record-breaking rainfall. People have been ordered to stay indoors. Schools and the stock exchange are shut for Monday. Koinu had weakened into a severe tropical storm but still brought gale-force winds and heavy rains. Landslide warnings have been issued, with many areas of the mountainous city at risk after unusually wet weather. The 19th Asian Games comes to a close with host China dominating the medal tally. China took home 201 gold medals and 303 medals in total. That's more than double the medal or than the medal haul of second place Japan and third place South Korea. Meanwhile, the Philippines ended its campaign in 17th place. Filipino athletes bagged 4 golds, 2 silvers, and 12 bronzes. Among the first place finishes was in men's basketball, where Gilas Pilipinas ended a 61-year gold medal drought.
60 years, you know, that's something, man, that's special. And like I said, I'm just happy that I can, we did it, you know, for the country, you know, with the team, happy for the whole team. And Coach Tim, he revenged his loss as well back in 1998, so happy for him as well.
Filipino boxing legend Manny Pacquiao is now a step closer to returning to the ring. The Philippine Olympic Committee has made a formal request to allow Pacquiao to compete as an amateur in the 2024 Paris Olympic Games. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. It's the Burr month, as we all know, which means those really into the Christmas season have already been putting up Christmas decorations. If you're among the early birds, there's a chance that the parol and Christmas ornaments you just brought were made by inmates at Camp Bagong Diwa in Taguig City. Likha Laya is an initiative of the jail warden and is aimed at giving inmates a source of livelihood. And for select inmates who have good records and charged with minor crimes, it's also a chance for them to earn money.
Kaya sa ating mga kababayan, nakikiusap ko na suportahan natin ang mga gawang kulungan dahil hindi lang ito basta palamuti, ngunit punong-puno ito ng pag-asa.